Unmentionable. We dare not speak his name. Lives behind closed doors, it seems. People are not very keen to speak about this. But the media loves it in its worst forms. Dear listeners, tonight I want to speak to you about a difficult subject, domestic violence. And up front, I want to acknowledge that this can be difficult, and if any of you are stimulated by something that I say tonight, check in with me later. Domestic violence comes in a variety of forms, in fact. Financial, physical, sexual violence, emotional violence. And it seems that we don't want to talk about it too much. But it's a very big issue. It's a big enough issue for there to be a Royal Commission report handed down today with 227 recommendations. It's a big enough issue for a fairly well-known footballer 2 days ago to publish an interview about his life. It's a big enough issue for a state politician to reveal her life and her family on television last night. It's a big enough issue for me to get up off my ass and want to do something about it. I'm a trainer in non-violent action, a non-violent activist, a facilitator of groups. And this is what leads me to become involved in this. I had a look, partly in preparation for this speech, but out of interest, at a Relationships Australia website. And they were quoting Australian Bureau statistics regarding domestic violence from a couple of years ago, because it takes a long time for these figures to filter through. And right up front there, it was noted from the Australian Bureau of Statistics, this is a difficult procedure, because people don't like to talk about this. It noted from the Australian Bureau of Statistics that people feel there's a stigma about domestic violence. It lives behind closed doors, perhaps. We see it in the media. In its worst forms, when it breaks out into violence and a murder or some sad thing. One of the statistics quoted there, a confidential survey, juxtaposing the people in a current relationship who identify them as being subject to domestic violence. Half of those people were men, and a quarter of them were women. But they only revealed that within the confidential survey. They'd not reported that anywhere else. And it's a tricky thing. Do we want to get the law involved in something personal? It's part of my work in an organisation that I'm connected with. To actually make this a conversation that's more accessible to people. We don't necessarily want to go to the extent of the law being involved. That creates a really difficult situation. Yet in some cases that has to be. I work with the Blue Wren Foundation and we run programs on lying in the sand. You see, people in that program have worked with men's groups and domestic violence for a long time. And they note that a lot of groups like that always end up working after the fact when someone's been taken to court. They all have prevention written into their mission statement, but they all end up working reactively rather than proactively. Line in the sand. We are all potentially violent people. We all have the capacity within But in this situation where we're driven, where things are frustrating for us, how willing are we to stop at a particular line of the sand and say, no, I will not go any further with this, and seek help? It seems like there are many men who won't do that, but it's not only men. This may be confronting for me to speak about this in this situation. But I want to support you in shining a light in these places that are uncomfortable, because that's how we get at ease with them, by talking about it with people, bringing it out from behind the closed doors, helping people handle it. So it's a challenge for you, it's a challenge for me, to take a step of domestic violence awareness. There's never been a better time for it, in fact, because of out there in community consciousness, there is a change, a will to do this. So that's partly why I'm standing here in front of you. That's partly why I'm taking actions in my own personal life. Because I want to make the world a better place for my children, my grandchildren, and yours as well. The line in the sand. Be aware of it and support others around.